was at the bridge of Diaz and baptism, died in Christ, so that he may resurrect with him eternal life. And after that, we shall cover the casket in the hall. That reminds us of the white cloth, that each one of us dressed himself for all has a thing during our individual baptism with our company words, that you have now become a new creature, helped by your friends and your family. Keep this divinity, presentably unstained, until you find the power of God. And the only way we find this to God is by going through life of brother, which is going through life. And we have the Easter candle that reminds us of the thing from Christ for the dead, telling us our death has no final word. The final word is in God, and our final testimony is not standing at God. With these few words, we now begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The waters of baptism, Richard Diaz died in Christ, and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him the time of glory. In life, Richard Diaz cherished the gospel of Christ. When Christ now prayed him with these words of eternal life, "Come, blessed of my Father."
Bring from above, echoes of mercy.
Hear our prayers on the behalf of your servant, Richard Diaz, whom you have called out of his world, and because he put his hope and trust in you, command that he be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal world. We ask this through our Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
We are now going to sit and listen to the scriptures. And now we are going to listen to the first reading.
Thank you.
Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith also in you. In my Father's house there are many, many places. If they were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come back again to take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I'm going, you're not going. Thomas said, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel. As began the procession and sang that opening song, this is my sorrow. This is my song. And I just said to myself today, we are here to join the story of the life of Richard. There seems to be the same even in moments like this, because when with some running late, when I went to check what was going on, the scouts say it's the same. The scouts do not give time. As we began this sharing the story of the creation, allow me on behalf of the and my own behalf express our heartfelt condolences to the family and friends of our brother Richard Diaz. I have to say that he was a very, very important man in this parish for a long, long time before I was born. And he said that he lost us. So as we affirm his loss, united in solidarity as family and friends, we wanted this time as an opportunity to express with our presence whatever we did not express to Richard while we live in our midst. You know, in life we take a lot for granted. Even turning around and saying, thank you, Richard, for the many things you have done for me, we fail. But we want to take this as an opportunity, even in the state in which it is, in our presence, to express that gratitude to him. And above all, to express God our gratitude for the opportunity of sharing in his very well-lived life. Yes, you may cry at his home. And it's not use, because grieving is healing. But at the same time, you must be grateful to God for all the experiences that you enjoy.
Thank you.
One thing that we all know is the fact that one thing, just like our brother, our friend, Richard, I have died. fear consumes us due to the uncertainty of the after-death experience to both the departed and those left behind. So, in times like this of death, there's nothing more important than time to the one of God for consolation. The first thing that was taken from the book of wisdom gives us the reason for not being afraid. The souls of the just are in the hands of God, and no government shall touch them. They are passing away though an affliction, but they are in peace. This is one of the convictions that Richard Diaz preached. The peace of the Greek, the peace the believer enjoys in the world after all the earthly challenges. On many occasions, after the death of his beloved wife Iris, my beloved friend, she loved me in passion. I remember one time when she was in the hospital, she never wanted to talk to Richard with me. And Richard became jealous of me. I think it was there, and she really laughed. And Richard used to say to me, I know just like myself how much you miss me. But she is at peace. Among the celebrations that Richard never missed, even when he was sick, was Ash Wednesday and All Souls Day. You never miss coming to church. To me, this pointed to this acknowledgement of his continuous preparation so that he may be found worthy when the Lord calls him. But also the need to pray for our faithful departed. Ones not only on All Souls Day, but during the entire month of November. This, it is no wonder that God called him during this month of November, a time to devote ourselves to praying for our faithful departed. And now it comes one day. And Richard was not only devoted to his church, but he was also a very devoted citizen, because he had waited until the voting is over to see that he gets a new president. And unfortunately, because of some irregularities, he waited in vain and said, Richard was a man, so devoted. So he devoted his love and time for the boys' house, even at the expense of his own transformation. There are times he will come when he is really sick, but he felt it was his obligation to instruct the younger ones so that they can be responsible citizens. That was at the expense of his own transformation. But there's one thing I want to remark on that. He did all that with a very high sense of humor. I remember on several occasions during the Boy Scout masses, he would pass by the sacrist and stop and sit back and want to go confession. And I will listen. And I will tell you that don't make the mistake of accepting. Because if I go to that confession, several occasions, and that's why I put that knob over there to time it in her jeans. And say, Father, that's for us, remember, not to preach too long. But if you make a mistake, it's Father. If you make a mistake, I'm going to mute the mic. And you understand. And that's why today I have the privilege of preaching for 2 hours. Because you cannot mute my head. But after that, we conclude with a very light heart and say, Father, we love you. This is the type of person that we have lost. I do miss him just as I miss my beloved friend Iris Diaz, his beloved wife. But my consolation, we should be our consolation, is that both of them were very good people. And not only good, they were very strong in their faith. And now they are in the hands of God. We know how much they love each other. And I'm sure Iris should have this smiling to Richard and asking him, hi, why did it take you too long to join me? And that was my immediate concern when Iris passed, because experience shows that two people who love each other dearly, no matter who each other in death, we have an experience of equal power. It never took a long time for Francis to follow him. The Gospel of John that we have just listened to has been set in the upper room, where the disciples had eaten a Passover meal with Jesus. And Jesus knew exactly what the next few hours and days would bring. He prepared his disciples to face the future without fear. The words, do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God and have faith also in me. We are addressed by Jesus to all his disciples, and we can rightly include ourselves in his audience and apply them to ourselves, our own hearts, as we mourn. Our beloved brother, Richard Diaz, as human beings, we are exposed to so many sorrows. Like the pain caused by death, and in our case, the loss of our brother Richard. What this passage teaches us is, while we cannot prevent the many losses in life, we are able to find strength and hope with the help of the Lord to get through. Jesus suggests to us that we should have faith in God and also have faith in him. What was actually saying was, you have trusted in God, it's now time to trust in me as well. And Jesus had a reason for emphasizing that, because he knew his own disciples were going to be scattered by the scum. We know when we meet process in life, what happens? We distance ourselves from God. We begin asking ourselves, but why, of all people, should this happen to us? And that's why Jesus reminds us that even in tough moments and days of loss, we should see our faith in him. One of the most amazing things that Jesus reveals is what is born in the Father's house. He says, in my Father's house there are many places. If there were not, then I've told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you. This is one of the consoling truth of the gospel. The fact that God dwells somewhere in a permanent place. What Jesus is telling us is that in God's house, which is heaven, there are so many God resting places to live. To me, it gives me such great comfort that I can know for sure that Jesus has already prepared a good resting place for me in heaven to live after all my earthly troubles. You know that when I die, like our beloved brother Richard, yes, I'm going to my father's house, where I'm accepted and loved, where I'm not a guest, but a residence, a place I call home. It gives me such great comfort. And likewise, it should give all of us comfort that Richard, our brother, has gone home. Another very consoling truth is the promise of Jesus of coming back. And he says, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come back and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may. Think of it. Jesus does not only show us the way. He does not only write out instructions about how to get heaven, but promises to come and personally take each one of us, like he has done our prayer to the Father's house. The time and the manner it takes each one of us may be different, but the consolation remains where it takes us. Paul expounds on this very truth, the second reading, when he says, we know that if our African tent should be destroyed, we have a gift from God, the friend, not made of hands, eternal in heaven. Of course, we may not necessarily understand the concept of the tent in the time of Paul, because we are all living in the modern world. But I have a better picture. Because my environment is not your environment. We used to take care of cows. We would go on the mountains. And when it would become very hot, we would make our own natural tents. It's not those type of tents that you cows have stored at the bar. When you go camping, you carry them and bring them home. I was astounded myself. Like our tents were different. We'd manufacture our own tents. We'd go there, you get all the leaves of bananas, and you make a tent. And after camping, you not never carry those things home, but you bring those things. At a camping site. That should help us understand what Paul was talking about. And for sure, Richard then, Diaz had that conviction. He knew that our bodies are just a tent. You remember, when Irish pastor, he never allowed a casket to be opened, said that body has no more value. I know God has called him. Many people requested the casket to be open. It's only you who have privilege as a beloved friend of Irish also. The rest of you desire that you not. But it still becomes, it's in fact a head. And it invites us to walk by faith and not by sight. Nature had a personal faith in the cross of our sin. And we always get very disappointed If by mistake urine is not mass, a crossbearer was not ahead of a procession. You know what he would command you to offer, because he knew the cross was to be ahead of the procession when the scouts were coming for mass. Because he knew and acknowledged the power of the cross as a sign of Jesus' victory over death. Yes, with eyes of faith, death for a living is a wonderful thing. And it's again, for death takes us to a better place where there are no more sorrows or suffering. Richard is no more going to shout snow, it's done. He's no more going to be burdened with any bill to pay. The IRS is not going for him anymore, because I called upstairs now for the direct line and I checked. There's no IRS in there. That means death takes us to a better place. It's our prayer that our brother Richard may merit the home that Jesus has prepared for those who give him. May God welcome him with all the saints to continue living with him and his love forever. For our faith assures us that life of a believer does not end with death, but is transformed to everlasting life. For Jesus, from his death and resurrection, opened the gates of heaven to everlasting life. Therefore, death has no final word. It is God who has the final word, as Jesus assures us in the gospel of today, that is the truth, the way and the life that leads us to the Father. We continue united in prayer with our brother Richard, that he may rest in peace until we meet him in heaven to share our communion with him and with the Lord. I'm sure Richard would want us to honor his legacy by continuing to live our lives to the fullest, and much as we extremely miss him, and for sure we miss him in his soul, and the source of all our faithful encounter through the merciful Christ. We now stand and offer our petition. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in our Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
Hear our prayer.
Our brother Richard Diaz was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the living and quick. Risen Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
May your friend and members of our family have found the forest and the way and the way to kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your son. Risen Lord, in your mercy.
Give our bread.
Family and friends of Richard Diaz seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Risen Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Richard Diaz, strengthen our hope that we may live in expectation of your son's coming. Risen Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Lord God, give us peace and heal our souls. Hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your kingdom. We ask this through Christ.
Amen.
Mercy.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to
who are in neighborhood, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make God therefore this gift, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them that they do form, so that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring us the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Timothy our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Richard Diaz, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he was united with your son in the death that he is, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of their resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Our mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be compared to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him, and with him, and in him. O God, O my Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord's command, and formed by divine teaching, and there to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious and grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace, I leave you my peace, I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And gracious grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
And now let us offer each other the sacrifice.
Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey. Must we grant that strengthened by it, our brother Richard Diaz may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Okay, yes. I want to express my sincere appreciation to all of you for creating time to be part of this celebration in which we accompany our Father. I made sure I don't disappoint him, and that's why I was checking on the same clock, because he'll be pointing so that I work within the framework of 1 hour, because we began 5 minutes late. It's now 11:05. So it's not mad with me, I'm sure of that. Because that's what he used to do during the parish council. He was on the parish council for the longest time. And I would still have so many points say, you man, this is not Africa. Here we keep time. But I told him I remain an African. So with us, time goes by even until it's done. Then he said, that's okay. So I don't know whether the family has something to say or we proceed.
Richard Diaz, born June 21st, 1936, left us on November 5th, 2020. 84 years, and then some. How do you sum up in just a couple of minutes what that means? What that means to his family, his sons, my brother, his sister, his grandsons, his nieces, his nephews, so many. How do you sum that up in just a couple of minutes? It's not easy. I thought long and hard about what I would say today. Not even sure if I would actually get up and actually say anything, worried that I wouldn't be able to get through it. Definitely worrying my wife that I would not be able to get through it without saying a few okays and some other things. But I just want to just say a few words about my dad. Growing up with my dad was not always easy, but lots of times it was a lot of fun. We had some really fun, good times. He taught me how to fish. He taught me how to shoot a bow. He taught my brother the same things. I don't think he did as well with my brother on the fishing thing because my brother seemed to get himself hooked a couple of times there. We ended up in the emergency room, but that's another story for another day. He had a big heart. He cared about a lot of things. He cared about sports, we know that. A few years ago, I blamed my grandfather because he made me a Mets fan, and I blamed my father for not letting me not be a Mets fan. I blamed my father for making me a Jets fan. I am stuck being a Jets fan. Of course, someday my kids will be standing somewhere saying, Dad, thanks a lot. He had a great love for helping others. And to those scouts here, from those from the scouts family who are here today, I say you're welcome. Now you're gonna probably say, why is he saying you're welcome? We didn't say thank you to him. Well, you should be saying thank you to me, because it all started on a Thursday night many, many years ago when I was about 8 years old, and I was 8 years old, and I joined PAC 185. And at the end of the PAC meeting, as the PAC meeting was coming to a close, then Scoutmaster, Cubmasters, they were standing there and they turned as they always did and said, you know, we could use some volunteers to help. We could always use some more parents to give us a hand. And little 8-year-old Richard went, ooh, mom, dad. And before you know it, that night, they were enlisted and they started. And all these years later, they were still doing it until my mom couldn't do it anymore. And of course, until recently when Dad physically was just not able to keep up with it. But it still was something that they did for all those years, touched a lot of lives. I know it made some of us unhappy at times, but made some of us very happy at times. How do you sum it up in just a few words? You can't. It's impossible. But what I say is, and I've said this about my mother, and I say it about my father, there's a testament to a life well lived. And that testament is that this moment, there are so many whose lives have been touched by him, that you're here today to share not only your grief, but your joy in the fact that he has gone on to a better place. And he'll be with my mother, and the two of them will start to antagonize each other, as they did quite often. They won't let that one go. I'm sure, I just to digress a moment, I'm sure my mother was standing there with St. Peter going, well, hey, well, let's talk about this. I just want to say, I thank you all for being here, for sharing this with us, for helping us get through. I will miss him. I will miss our conversations. In fact, one of the last conversations we had was kind of funny. We're sitting there, he's in the hospital, and we're sitting there and he looks at me and he says, well, the Jets stink, the Mets stink, what can we talk about? But we did always find stuff to talk about, and I will miss that. He will be missed by many. He was loved by many. And I love him and will miss him always.
Brother Richard Diaz. And now we come to the last film. The sadness in the party. But we take comfort in hope that one day we shall see Richard again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the Mass of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ. We shall all respond, receive his soul, and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come with aid. Hasten meet angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul.
Present him to God the Most High. May Christ who has called you take you to himself. May the angels lead the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul.
Eternal rest grant him, O Lord, and let perpetual life upon him. May he rest in peace.
Amen.
Receive his soul and present him to God.
Bless the